So now that we know how to make and use variables, how to compare them, and what we can do with those comparisons, let's move on to another foundational concept of computer science, arrays. Now we already talked about variables and how great they are for storing singular bits information for making our code more simplistic. But one of the biggest drawbacks that come with variables is their inability to hold more than one piece of different information. For example, let's say you are making an app which allows users to create a grocery list. Well, there's no easy way to create lists using variables, because it's not like you can have one variable store the names of 7 or 8 different food items. Remember, we can only put one piece of paper in our cardboard box, no more. And besides, even if you were to add multiple items to one string variable, you still would have a lot of trouble doing simple tasks you might want from a list, like searching through it or splitting it, or even deleting items from the list when you are done with them. This is the problem that using arrays solves for us. An array is, as you may have guessed by now, a list. You can have an array of integers, an array of strings, and even an array of other arrays, which is something we will cover in a minute. Programmers use arrays when they want to store a lot of variables containing information which is related to each other, such as a grocery list or a high school list in a game. Think of arrays as a column in Excel or Google Sheets. You have the title at the top, and then below it are a bunch of bits of information which all relate to the title. Arrays are super useful when programmers want to store a lot of information that can be easily searched through, because programmers have developed methods of breaking down and using arrays to find specific information in arrays full of thousands of different variables. As an example, to show just how useful arrays are, let's say you are a startup company that owns an app that has 100,000 users. Every time a user wants to create a new account, they input the username that they want, and then your program will have to check to make sure the account name hasn't already been taken. Doing this requires you to search through the information of all 100,000 of your users to see if that username has an account with your service. An array will be able to contain all of this information and make it easy to search through and find out if the account name has been taken with little to no delay. Now, the single most important thing to note about arrays is how you reference each element of the array within them. Let's create a basic array called numbers, and inside of it put the digits 1 to 10. Now we want to refer to each cell in this array. We call upon its index. An index is just a fancy way of saying that numbers are placed within the array. Now you will think that the first integer in this array will be the first index, the second will be the second index, and so on. But that's not the case. In computer science, programming languages refer to the first cell as the zero element in the array. This means that if we were talking about our array of numbers we just made, the number 4 would actually be in the third index, 5 would be in the fourth index, and so on. So instead of starting our count from 1, we start from 0. It's extremely weird and confusing, but it's one of those programming quirks you are going to have to memorize and commit to memory. If you were to not follow this nomenclature and you refer to the last element in this array as the 10th, you get what is referred to as an out-of-bounds error, since you are trying to reference the 10th element, but there is no 10th element. What you are actually trying to do is reference the 9th element. Another extremely important thing to note about arrays has to do with the size. When you initialize an array, you can do it either one of two ways. You can either populate it with the elements that you want contained in the array right then and there, creating and filling the array at the same time. Or you can define how many elements you want in the array, essentially the array size, and then populate it with elements later. This is because when we initialize an array, it creates a space in memory that has a size of exactly what you give it. No more, no less. This is great for when we want to access elements in the array, because we can do so instantaneously. But the one downside is that we can't increase the size of the array later on. All array sizes are final. Think of it like setting up a bookshelf with books. By populating a bookshelf with a certain number of books and then moving on and filling the next shelf with different books, we have no way to go back and add books to the first shelf without shifting everything. Once we decide how much space to dedicate space for an array, in this case, there's no way to add more space. Once again, because this is extremely important to remember, this means that once an array has been defined, there's no way to change the size of it. If you have an array titled names with size of 8 and you try to add another name to the array, you will receive an error. So be careful when messing around with array sizes. Of course, you can always go back at the start of the code when you initially make the array and allocate more space to it if you find out you need more space to hold items. But once it's defined, you cannot change its size. Another small thing I want to touch upon really quickly is that when you initialize an array, you must determine which type of array it is right then and there. For example, you have to specifically say it will be an array of strings or integers when defining it, and also you are not allowed to mix and match, meaning you can't have an array full of integers with a few strings and some doubles thrown into the mix. They have to be all the same type. Now the last thing we are going to cover on arrays is a little funky, and that is the practice of putting arrays inside of arrays. If you make an array of arrays, it's referred to as 2D or two-dimensional array. Think of this as matrices. If any of you have taken algebra classes, now if you haven't, think back to our Google Sheets example, but instead of just columns, we would add rows as well. So now each element in our array wouldn't simply be just a string variable or an integer variable, but an entirely new array with its own set of values and elements. The way we index this is mostly the same, except we would have two numbers to index instead of one. We start with the row and then the column. So a number in the position 0, 2 would be in the first row, three columns down, in this case, name Steve. A number in the position 1, 1 would be two rows down and two columns across, in this case, the name Jones. You get the idea. Now you can also make three-dimensional arrays by putting an array inside an array inside an array, but that's a little above what we are going to be covering, so I'm gonna cut off here.